All right, party people, let's talk about exponential decay. We worked on exponential growth and we took a long look at that. So this should be a relatively short video moving on into the wonderful world of decay when things are falling apart rather than growing. Okay, so here's a table. I want you to tell me if it represents an exponential function. If so, let's write a rule for it. One of the things that we are also going to focus on here pretty soon is I will be giving you probably not graphs because they're a little bit, well, we'll do some graphs, and but a lot of tables. And what we're going to do is you're going to have to recognize whether or not the what you're seeing is a linear function or an exponential function. Okay, and we'll talk a little bit more about that later and do that in class. But right now, let's talk about when we have things that are decaying. All right, so if it's going to be decaying, which in this case you can see as x increases, okay, y is also increasing, so we're going to talk about if this is an exponential function or not. Okay, so as x goes up, y is going up. Therefore, we know that we're multiplying by 3, so my base is 3. So that when y is, and we know the starting point here is going to be 1/3. Okay, so that would be 1/3 times 3 to the x power. Okay, and this would be exponential growth because my base is 3. Okay, it's tripling each time. So let's take a look at this one. Now, as we look at this, you can notice that x is increasing while y is decreasing. Okay, so it goes from 4 to 1 to 1/4 to 1/16. All right, now maybe, I mean, I hope you can see that this is dividing by 4 each time. Okay, the other option is you can look at it is if you look at this backwards, you can see that as x decreases, y is quadrupling, right? It's increasing. It's getting bigger and bigger. So then with the reverse, as I go backwards here, I'm going to divide by 4 each time. So we know that our base here is going to be divide by 4. Okay, so how do you write divide by 4? Another way of saying if I'm going to be dividing, whoa, that's not what I want. If I want to be dividing by 4, right, divide by 4, okay, that is the same as multiplying by 1/4, okay? Because remember, this is saying divide it into 4 pieces, okay? This is saying cut something into 4 pieces, keep one of them, okay? And that's essentially the same. If I take 4 and I cut 4 into 4 pieces and keep one of them, I'm left with 1. And if I cut this into 4 pieces, I get quarters, and keep one of them, I get 1/4. And if I cut those into 4 pieces, I get 16ths. Keep one of those, I get 1/16. And on and on and on. Okay? The next one you should notice would be 1/64. Okay? So we know that we're multiplying by 1/4. That would be my base. I look to 0 to see what my starting point is. My starting point is 0. I'm sorry, my starting point 0 is when y is 1. So I know that a is going to be just 1. So I know that my function is 1/4 to the x power. At the end of this, I'm going to have you play around with what these are actually looking like. I'm not going to have you graph them yet. We'll graph them a little bit in class and practice there. But I do want you to play around a little bit with the graphing calculator with decimals so you can have an idea of what it looks like as the base. You know, as we manipulate the base here, you can see sort of what happens to the graph. All right, so why don't you try this one? Why don't you go ahead and you see if you can write this function as y equals a times b to the x power. So go ahead and see if you can figure this out. All right, so hopefully you looked at this and you said, okay, as x is increasing, right, as this goes up by 1, each time I increase x by 1, y keeps being divided by 5, right? It gets 1/5 smaller. Okay, and so as you see, as x is increasing by 1, I see that y is dividing by 5. I look to see what my starting point is. My starting point is 1. So I know that I'm going to get y is equal to 1/5 raised to the x power. Okay, so each time I'm dividing by 5. Okay, hopefully you are seeing this pretty easily. All right, so this is the opposite of exponential growth, okay? And you'll see when we start graphing these how it really looks like the opposite, okay? And oftentimes what we do is we say that it's declining by a percentage each time, okay? And one of the things that you'll notice that we're going to use a lot of, and you'll see this a lot when people talk with chemistry or when you use it in science, is that this idea of half-life. And we'll talk a little bit more about that in class. And you'll see on the graph that from left to right, it will go down. All right, so what does this look like? Same idea as our exponential growth model, except what's going to happen here is that my output is going to be equal to A times 1 minus the rate at which it decreases. And then T is the time again. Okay, so A is my initial amount. It's the starting point. It's when the exponent, in this case T, is 0. R is the decay rate. And make sure you understand when you talk about the decay rate at what time unit we're using. 1 minus R is the decay factor. And we'll talk a little bit more about why that's important to know that the decay, what the decay factor is. And finally, T is the time period. And again, very important, make sure that the time period that you're utilizing matches the rate, okay? The unit, the time unit in the rate. All right, well, that's pretty much it. There's a second link that on your email that I'm attaching to, or I'm sorry, there's another email. Sorry, let's try this again. There is another link at the bottom of your email. I would like you to go through. There should be a couple of sliders on there if this thing worked the way I wanted it to. I want you to go ahead, click play, just mess around, manipulate the different variables, and just kind of get a good idea of what works, what happens with it, okay? And I'm going to ask you in class what you think is going to change, like maybe compare the difference between two of them, and hopefully you'll get a good idea of what that looks like. All right. Good luck. Have fun.